So next we'll discuss show your guest room and not a garage or storeroom of yours. When somebody visit your profile, someone sees your resume. And nowadays, everyone is living a real life and a social media virtual life. People follow you and they try to see what type of person you are through your LinkedIn profile, through your Facebook profile, what type of friend groups you follow. So that's what I wanted to share through show your guest room, not storeroom. Make sure your LinkedIn profile is up to date. You have right endorsement. Make sure if you have 20 skills, most of them has got at least 10 or 20 endorsement for the most skills you feel you are strongest in. Now ready, the next one is ready with your elevator pitch. I'm not talking about presenting your idea to an investor in an elevator. For that you need to prep and make your elevator pitch. For elevator pitch for a job seeker can be a 30 second to 1 minute introduction of his entire career, which give a good insight to the hiring manager, recruiter, or the person who is a headhunter and looking for a candidate for the job. So let's say whenever you apply for a job, do a little search about the company. I'm not talking about the contract roles. I'm talking about full-time role here. But for contract role, at least see what type of role this is, in which department it is, and see if you have any connections in LinkedIn. Look for people who can refer you internally, people with similar field, any new topic or industry search coming to that relevant area or department can be very useful during your interview. So my being a quality assurance professional, if I am searching for the jobs, my elevator pitch or a recruiter ready pitch will be, "Hi, my name is Gaurav. I'm actively looking for quality assurance, disposition, batch record review, quality system or quality compliance role. I have 8+ years of experience working with diversified pharmaceutical and biopharmaceutical company. I've worked in quality operations, quality systems, quality compliance and dispositions." So this can be my elevator pitch. Now the next is webinar, LinkedIn groups, meetup and career fair. I don't know how many of international students has a practice of attending webinar. When I was an international student, every day I search for free webinar for the field which I am actively looking for jobs. For example, if you are looking for quality documentation job, which is a very startup or a 0 experience to 1 year experience job. Further, if you are looking for quality training jobs, which require minimum to 1 year of experience, look for free webinars on these topics. I'm sure you will find few. If you don't, just search on YouTube, you'll find some relevant videos. Try participate on those online webinar. Second, LinkedIn group. Join a LinkedIn group. See how people are putting their question. Like for example, I have became a member of cleaning validation and autoclave steam sterilization groups on LinkedIn. So few interview question I already prepped from the discussion happened during this group. It's an also an important opportunity, like let's say a hiring manager or a person who may not be hiring right now but on a good position posted a question and you did some research and you replied in a comment that hi XYZ, based on my research, I don't have a practical experience, neither I consider myself as a expert in this field. However, my research and after reading few articles or guidance document, I feel that these should be the answer of your query or concern. This leave a big impression on the person, and who knows, in near future if he is hiring, he may reach out to you. Then meetup. Everyone is exploring different social media platform. Meetup is one of those. Go on Meetup website, see a suitable group you can find for networking. Find people who with your similar interest, who either looking for job, who are either in headhunting industry, who are either HR professional, who are quality assurance, regulatory affairs, or anyone with your areas of expertise, and see if you can network with them. Career fairs. So in Boston is a startup hub. Cambridge, there are many career fair happening in the month of January until the winter ends, until April. Look for online, register to career fair. They are free. Walk in there, talk to everyone. Bring your resume, share your resume with everyone. Even if the jobs are not relevant, just try and present yourself to the hiring manager. Mention that your interest is in pharmaceutical, biopharma, or any type of industry you are looking. And who knows, they may circulate your resume to the right person. And nowadays, in career fair, they hand over you a tablet or a digital board where you can enter all your detail, and your resume phone number goes into their database, and whenever they need someone like you, they'll call you back. Also, I used career fair as a chance to present myself, brush up my skills, presenting how I hold myself when I discuss or network with anybody else. Now the last one is Craigslist search. So Craigslist search, as I mentioned, Boston is a startup hub. There are many clinical stage companies. There are many technology based companies. There are many production companies. So some companies are very small who don't even have a HR department. Very limited people are doing the whole sum of work, including the networking as well. So all you need to do, they use the free job board, and Craigslist is the free job board. So go to Craigslist, put your keywords of job and search. I'm sure you will end up with some of the job requirements which are meeting with your needs. So with these, I would like to bring your attention on how to get more calls. So I'm sure that if you do all these things on day-to-day basis, you will certainly increase the probability of getting more calls. And once you have those calls, try to use them, because the calls are the first step toward getting the job. There are three more steps, like your telephonic interview, your on-site interview, and your HR interaction, and then the offer letter and background search. So I wish all the good luck to everyone who is looking for a job. Try follow these steps, and I'm sure that you will end up your next role very soon. Thank you. Subscribe to the channel if you like the video, and comment me if you have any other question. I'll be doing separate videos on other topics that I may not be covering in this video, but wish you all the luck again. Thank you.